Hey everybody, this is Perch, and let's talk about this news that Dark Horse has been sold. So if you go on the Wayback Machine about, the Wayback Machine of a year and a half, how our perspectives are funny. A year and a half, I mentioned that Dark Horse was actively trying to get sold, and they were courting some different entertainment companies, including Marvel and Disney. And I know that there were at least some cursory looks at the company. But first off, I want to point out that this is not terribly unusual. This is the exit strategy for a lot of companies. For people who are reading comics in comics, a lot of indie comic creators, this may seem shocking to you, but, and I don't mean that sarcastically, but the point of a lot of the companies that are getting made is to ultimately flip and be sold. Nobody's trying to open up a mom and pop comic business that's going to survive forever. They're trying to get some IP together, get some momentum, sell it to somebody bigger, pocket some cash, move away. These are the people that you don't typically hear from, the people who are coming up with these plans. Instead, we're hearing from, you know, comic writers, comic editors. We're hearing from people much lower in the company who are really just trying to put out comics, maybe getting paid, maybe wanting to use the platform that they now have to bitch at other people, whatever it happens to be. The people at top are trying to make money. The goal is to, of course, have as little stake out in the company as possible, so that when it sells, you pocket that cash and you give it to your investors and others, and everybody gets a nice return. Where things get underwater is if the company takes a lot of money. They take a lot of debt, they take a lot of investors, and basically it's called cramming down the people who are at the top who are trying to make money for themselves. If you have to pay off everybody else first and you have to pay off your debt, there's not much of a profit left, you don't make much money. So anyway, I feel like I'm doing, primer version, nothing with a comic, but just the entry level version of what it means to make a company and flip it and sell it. But at any rate, what's the news? The news is that Dark Horse Comics has been sold to the Embracer Group. That's a Swedish entertainment company, sort of. It's a Swedish holdings company. And we'll explain what that means in a minute. But basically, this company has a large number of properties and IPs. It boasts over 250 IPs, 8 different operative groups, 86 development studios, over 9,000 people, 40 countries. That last one's really kind of irrelevant to everything else. But the Embracer Group was once known as THQ. You probably recognize that name, but THQ Nordic, AB. Now, what's AB? These are the companies that are basically traded in the Swedish NASDAQ. They're Swedish holdings companies. So what's a holdings company? Because this is important. So a holdings company is basically, it's a parent business entity. It's a corporation. It doesn't make anything. It doesn't sell anything. All it does is invest and own other companies. A holdings company basically grabs up different groups, different companies, different interests. It positions them. It gives them some credibility. Oftentimes, holdings company gives access to capital, which is why they're attractive to small companies. They're able to raise money or have the credibility of being part of a company. And they are able to, what they're looking for is that one of these holdings, one of these companies they've bought, will go big. Now, they know on the offset that most of the companies will not. So it's not, they're not betting that everything they invest in is going to do great. What they're hoping for is that when they invest in a number of these companies, that one is going to do 10x what they paid for it or the money they put in, while the others either break even or maybe even lose money. And in many cases, holding companies can remove things as well. They're basically traders. And when I say traders, I mean trading companies. So they're going to get a company, they're going to try and maximize it. Sometimes, and I think this is the case with Dark Horse, when they take the company, what they're really hoping is that something that the company that they took, something they have, might be plugged in with another company they have, and the combination of the two parts can do more. And why I think that's what's going on here to some extent is that because they do have a lot of these game companies, entertainment companies, they're viewing Dark Horse and saying, you've got, on paper, you claim to have about 200-ish IPs. Now, some of those are tied up in legal rights. In some cases, the creators have first right of refusal or they're owning the property. So how many properties Dark Horse owns free and clear is a little bit trickier to kind of understand. But anyway, they've got a lot. And so what they're hoping is that they can take these comic properties, this IP, and they can plug it into one of the game companies or one of the entertainment companies or one of the groups that is making movies. Because right now in Sweden, there's a heavy amount of entertainment companies trying to basically cram out content that they're having a lot of success right now flipping to Netflix and others. So it's this goes into a whole other topic, but there's a business right now in Sweden, a healthy business of making these shows somewhat on the cheap and using loans from other countries, making these properties, serving them back. That's why if you go to Netflix and you kind of surf around on some of their properties, you'll eventually run into a lot that seem to be Nordic in creation. But anyway, so that's what's going on. Embracer, they, as a holdings company, they primarily, but not exclusively, specialize in basically entertainment companies, content companies, film and TV production, content development, IT development, etc. And like anything in the press release, Embracer is saying that Dark Horse owns or controls more than 300 intellectual properties. They most certainly do not, but that's fine. They're looking at how they take these things lots of places. Now, one interesting facet to all this is Embracer is adept, in fact, I would argue more adept, at delivering content internationally to other markets, to other countries. They have less of a footprint in the US. So what I do kind of wonder about it is how much of Dark Horse's IP is going to be positioned in markets that most of the people listening to this video right now will never actually see. There's a good chance that there will be successes within this purchase that will kind of completely fly under the radar for most of us, because it's going to be shopped to the EU, it's going to be shopped to South America. They're definitely playing in some aspects of Asia. And so I have a feeling you're going to see Dark Horse migrate more in that direction. But we'll see. We will see. So what does all this mean? It means that the race to kind of consolidate a lot of these companies is ongoing. Mike Richardson from Dark Horse is not going anywhere. The founder is still there. However, typically speaking, when a holdings company purchases up a property, the CEO or owners do tend to either migrate to an advisory board or leave within about 12 months. And the reason being is the holdings company is really looking to make sure that a company that they just invested in can play nicely with another company. So you get less strong CEOs and you get more deal-making CEOs. You get people who kind of sit in the middle. It's not uncommon in holdings company to have one CEO over two or three different companies and splitting their time. It's also not uncommon for there to be no CEO and for the board to actually control a lot of the environment. If I look at and do just a little bit of investigation into Embracer, Embracer, which is traded on the, that you can see, they're currently listed at 87,000 SEC. That's the currency in Sweden. What's interesting here is, as you go down, a lot of the companies that they've invested in, they don't have CEOs. They have basically these crossover managers, and so I wonder about some of that. Anyway, what comes next? I think Boom is definitely a studio that's basically begged. that's too strong a word, but would love to be acquired. A lot of these small companies would like to be acquired. I think you'll see more. There's a few more holdings companies out there that could do the same kind of thing, and I think Boom would probably be a good target for that. But you're going to see some international plays. You're going to see some material like this. I haven't looked yet at what all the hot takes are about this particular case. Maybe it's because I've been seeing and hearing about Dark Horse trying to sell for so long now, and it really has been a long time now, that none of this seems particularly surprising, shocking, or anything to me. It feels like something that was bound to happen. Will Dark Horse continue? Yes, I think you will see Dark Horse. I mean, Dark Horse is already in a model of shipping kind of limited series and these kind of one-off type titles. They weren't doing a lot of ongoing type stuff. So I don't think we'll notice much of a change there. I don't think that video game properties that Embracer holds, they hold, you know, like Saints Row and stuff like that. I don't, World War Z. I don't think you're suddenly going to see comic books off these properties. I don't think that's the point at all. I think it's going to go more the other direction, where the Dark Horse properties are going to get kind of served up, tuned, looked at, evaluated. The person to that I'm interested is who's going to come into Dark Horse to do this portfolio evaluation. Who are they going to hire? That's probably a very fascinating role for everyone listening to this to watch for. Somebody will come in and they're basically going to look at each of the, one of these properties. They're going to figure out, okay, this will make a good video game. This could make a good movie. This could make a good cartoon. This could make a mobile game, etc. Embracer is primarily games, as mentioned, but they do have a footprint in some of these other businesses. And somebody's going to come in and try and evaluate their portfolio. Who that person is going to tell us a lot about what's going to happen with Dark Horse, but it's also going to tell us a lot of what's going to happen with some of these other content companies and some of these other comics. And if you were a, say, Boom or IDW or Dynamite or somebody like that, right now, I would be getting somebody to put together for you a little portfolio deck that has your properties and has the different ventures that could happen from those properties. I'd have it ready. So if you have any interest in selling, if you have any interest in positioning yourself, that would be a smart thing to do. Anyway, that's the news, as dry as I can make it. I need a hot take in here. I don't have one. I don't know. It seems like there's a joke that I can make about Swedish people. Let's see. Nope, it's just not coming. So sorry about that. It's just not coming. Like, too dirty. Anyway, thanks for listening.